What do you think about when you're alone? Do you ever take the time to reflect on your own choices? Possible choices you can make? No, I'm not talking about sitting in the shower arguing with yourself. True, deep self-reflection. The type where you sit down and you connect with yourself. The feeling is almost equivalent to sitting down and undisassociating. Is that even a word?
I guess I made it up.
Realizing that you, yourself, are in fact a real person, capable of thoughts and free will. It's like realizing while shopping that you could say anything to anyone. You could mess with anyone in either a silly way or by being a complete ass. The choice is fundamentally up to you to make. It's a miracle, really, being able to have free thought and will. Now you're probably asking, why are you even bringing this up? Well, it's a fairly important skill to learn, especially during these times where most people see online and in public, question if they're even real people. Some might even call this critical thinking. So how do you encourage critical thinking, though? I'm kidding. Please, no. I'm kidding. That's not how. But have you ever done something without being simulated? Like driving, you're not listening to any music or anything. Doing just basic tasks without any sort of dopamine reward to them. So you become bored. You start thinking about the present or the past or even the future for all that matters. You just start thinking. Why not put that thinking to use? Why not think about something that could help you, benefit you instead?
Man, that's corny as fuck! Let's do some real critical thinking right now!
So, now, we're gonna be using our critical thinking skills, okay? So, we're gonna open up to E5, we're gonna create that opening right there, okay? Now, what he doesn't expect that we're gonna do is we're gonna move our horse to F6. He's gonna try to protect with the pawn, but we're not gonna let him take the middle. It's gonna be too easy, alright? So, right here, he's created a bit of a sideswipe, if I may say. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna strategically put that pawn right there. All right. Okay. Now we're gonna strategically put this piece here. So he's gonna take that. We're gonna take that, and his queen's gonna come down, or he's gonna move the pawn for no reason. Okay. I don't know what he's doing, but what we're gonna do is we're gonna play the move that I like to call boom. Okay, this guy, he's a complete idiot. Look at him. Look how cute he is.
Hello guys, it's Jovan, and you know what time it is? Disco time!
This guy's dumb. We're gonna get the horse into here. We're gonna break his defenses. He's not gonna know what hit him. He's gonna be too flabbergasted to know anything of what just happened. So right now, he's got the horse on the run. But we also have our horse, and he's gonna come down right here. He's not gonna be able to do anything. Now, if we can develop our pieces just a little bit better. So if we move our horse, if we actually don't move our horse, and put our bishop right here. It's actually gonna give us a better advantage right there. All right. Okay. So now he's doing it. He's taking a pawn. I'm gonna take a pawn. What he doesn't know is taking his mistake. He's not critically thinking. You see this time difference? This is critical thinking. This is not critical thinking. He doesn't expect this though. He won't even know. Oh. He won't even know what hit him. All right. He's not critically thinking. I am. He's not critically thinking, you know, because we're just. That's fine. We could both do that. It's too easy. Okay, so now he's done absolutely nothing, and he's wasted a bishop.
A few moments later.
We're gonna move down. We're gonna move right here. We're gonna try and cut him off. And he's given up. It's that easy.
Five blunders! What?
What am I doing? Now I've become stimulated. But how do you stop being stimulated then? I just need to... I don't know. I just need to go think of something. Just do anything that isn't sit in front of something and just mindlessly consume entertainment. I need to think for myself. Maybe I just have to figure out what to do. Maybe I just need to critically think of what to do.
About a week ago, I decided to go camping. I decided I wouldn't bring anything with me except for food, gear, the necessities you need to, well, survive. Seeing nothing but the vast mountain ranges and sparse vegetation, it awakens something inside of you. No external dopamine, no electronic stimulation, not even anything to pass the time. It's you, a fire, some water, the cool breeze, and the occasional murmur of an animal, or the birds chirping along as you sit, pondering. No mirrors to keep looking at yourself to judge yourself, it's simply you. You alone and your thoughts. I remember reading an article by The Zapier titled The Art of Being Bored. It talks about how life without experiencing boredom is one taken for granted. You learn to appreciate anything. You form your own creative thoughts, your own ideas. You become someone with free will.
One of the very first things said in this article is, in a world where people would rather administer shock therapy to themselves than be alone with their thoughts for 15 minutes. So, what do you think about when you're alone? This is just one of the examples of anywhere, really. You could go outside, you could look at the water or something. I don't know, whatever you want to do. You could sit in a car, you could watch homeless people, you could watch crackheads shooting up on the street. You could go anywhere. Like, the world's your backyard. You could come down to just a river or something. You could go to a lake, you could go to a creek. Honestly, it doesn't matter. Like, you can do whatever you want. You have your own choices. You can make those choices. If you don't want to, you don't have to make those choices. It's all up to you, really. It just depends on if you want to make them or not. So, yeah, you can critically think, but are you even able to get a job with this kind of knowledge? So, congratulations. You can now critically think, but you need to avoid being homeless somehow. So, what are the occupations that you can get now? So you can become a private investigator, a police detective, you can become a therapist, counselor, anything really that requires thinking or just common sense, which, congratulations, you've now acquired. You can now think for yourself. Now you can already bet I'm gonna be a little silly little police detective going down the street and, you know, doing my little silly little task. Eating a donut? Yep, that's me. To end off on a serious note though, I hope you enjoyed the slop that this video was. I hope you got the message of allowing yourself to feel
and not be consumed by blank slates of entertainment. Hopefully, after this, you start to see yourself for who you are. But the key point to take away is, think about anything, especially when you're alone.